question number 2. In question 3, both of them got 8 out of 10, both were equal. When you add up the marks of all the 10 questions, both student A and B got 80 out of 100. So in short, student A and student B are overall equal. In some question, A is higher than B. In some question, B is higher than A. In others, both are equal. In the same fashion, taking the example that since Allah has given man more strength, suppose a thief enters the house. Will you tell, I believe in women's rights? I believe in women's rights. Will you tell your mother, your sister and your daughter to go and fight the thief? No, but naturally you'll fight him. If required, they may interfere. Under normal circumstances, since Allah has given you more physical strength, you have to go and tackle the thief. So here, in physical strength, man is 1 degree higher than the woman. Let's take another example. Where it comes to respecting the parents, the children are supposed to respect the mother 3 times more than the father. Here, the women have 1 degree higher than the men. Overall, both are equal. So Islam believes in equality, not identicality. Men and women are overall equal in Islam. This was in brief, not in detail, as Justice Qazi said. Time does not permit me to speak in detail. This was in brief, the highlights of the women's rights in Islam. After this, what the Muslim society did is different. Many of the Muslim societies did not give the women their rights and they deviated away from the Quran and the Sunnah. The Western society is largely responsible for this. Because of the Western societies, many Muslim societies have become overprotective, overprecautious, and have gone to one extreme and deviated away from the Quran and the Sunnah. On the other extreme, some of the Muslim societies agreed with the Western culture and followed their culture. I want to tell the Western society that if you analyze the women's rights in Islam according to the Quran and the Sunnah, you will realize it's modernizing and not outdated. Lastly, I would like to thank those people who have helped and supported me. If there is any one person who requires credit for me being here, it's my beloved mother, Mrs. Roshan Naik. It was because of her love, care and guidance that I'm here today. I'll be doing injustice if I do not include the name of my father, Dr. Abdul Karim Naik, as well as my other family members, especially my brother, Dr. Muhammad Naik, and last but not the least, my wife, who has encouraged me since the last 1.25 years since we have been married, and thus I've been able to strive harder in this field. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.